All right, welcome back off-grid tours to the channel. Once again, we are in what I am now dubbing the concrete campsite. Now, Craig and I here, we spend a lot of our time setting up cars for you to get out there and tour. So hence why we get to hang out in the concrete car park a fair bit. All right, so today we've got this DMAX behind us here that we've done a fair bit of work to. So Craig, run me through it. What's the base of this system, the base reason behind we opted for these kinds of kits, and I guess what was the customer after?
Yeah, 100%. So essentially in this sucker, we've got 200 amp hour kit behind the seat with a 2000 watt inverter. So the biggest thing with this build is obviously it is going to be a single vehicle tourer, so it's not particularly towing. It's going to be like an all-in-one camper. So obviously space is an absolute premium in these things, or any car that's set up as a single vehicle tourer, especially with a style side tub on it. So keeping is, you know, this battery system out of the tray, which you traditionally have to do with a 200 amp hour or larger kit, we're able to squeeze it all in behind the back seat. So keeping all of that tray space as available as possible for whatever they want, obviously stacking as much stuff as possible like you need when you're going touring. But yeah, so 200 amp hour custom lithium kit behind the back seat, 2000 watt inverter, socket kit in the back, so it's going to run everything from coffee machines to induction cookers. We're going to run his fridge. You've got a 95 litre dual zone fridge, and yeah, all charged by 40 amp Redarc DC-DC, so it's getting charged up nice and quickly.
Awesome. Now, you made mention of a couple of different brands there. Can you run me through? Let's start with the battery. So why'd we opt for that particular battery for this car?
Easy. So the battery in this one is a custom lithium battery. They're based out of Brisbane, I think Brendale from memory. So they're an Australian company and they actually assemble the batteries in-house. So obviously Australian made is a big thing we like to stick with. But the main reason, to be completely honest, is actually the battery sizing. Because these guys custom make the batteries themselves in house, they really have, you know, a lot more control over casing dimensions and stuff like that. So they can really design the battery for specific purposes. And in this purpose, obviously we're super limited for room behind that back seat. So it's ultra slim and it's small enough and compact enough that it just fits in this super duper well. And we haven't found another battery that quite fits in behind the D-Maxes like these do. There are a couple other brands, like Inverter do one for a 79 series, but there's a bit more room behind a 79. These are really, really super duper space limited. So yeah, that's the main reason why I've gone with that custom lithium battery.
Awesome, and now with any dual battery system, we need a way to charge it. So what have we opted for in this particular vehicle and why?
100%. So this one's doing pretty much all off-grid work, so it won't be at caravan parks and the likes of. So we've just opted for the Redarc, the 40 amp DC to DC charger, or BC DC charger, the core variant because it's being kept inside, so the non-waterproof version because we're not using this as a submarine. So it's, yeah, so 40 amps of charge means that it's, you know, if you're driving for an hour, it's going to be replenishing 40 amps worth of charge out of that 200 amp hour battery, meaning that it doesn't take a lot of driving to get this sucker right back brimming full. And obviously, sticking with the Australian made theme, Redarc DC-DCs are all Australian made. So yeah, keeping it nice and Aussie made and local.
Where is it? Where do we end up putting it?
The DC-DC?
Yeah.
Yeah, so the DC-DC in this one, because the back wall's taken up with the inverter and the battery, it's actually under the passenger side of the rear seat. This is the D-Max, it's got a little storage under the back seat, little flap lifts up. So we've got the DC-DC and the fuse box actually all tucked in there out of the way. So once again, you know, trying to utilize or keep as much space available for the customer for their storage.
Yeah, not a worry at all. And to touch on DC chargers, obviously with any DC charger, be it trying to charge a caravan, an auxiliary battery, we like to put them, well, you should put them as close to the auxiliary battery you're charging as possible, just to minimize voltage drop. There's a bit of misconception around that. That's something we highly recommend and push. So all our systems, we try to make sure they are within pretty much under like a meter, if not closer to the auxiliary battery. Now, you mentioned they're all under the seat. Now, I go straight to accessibility. So, can we still easily access the charger and fuses if we need it?
100%. So, everything is super accessible. It's literally one strap you pull to lift the seat up. lift the lid up, it's right there. So literally 2 second job to actually access the DC-DC and the fuses. And we've left extra cabling on around the fuse box too. So it's accessible directly there, but if you ever need to take it out to fault find further, there's plenty of length on the cables to pull it out, making, you know, serviceability and accessibility super duper easy, which is obviously, you know, a must if you're doing some remote travel, so.
Awesome, now the big thing. Reason we've gone 200 amps is to be able to cater for a large inverter, correct?
Correct.
What are we using the inverter for? What inverter did we use and how have we set it up for the customer to be able to use it again, keeping in mind, you mentioned the inverter's mounted behind the seat, so not super accessible.
100%, so yeah, inverter's in behind the back seat. While on the D-Maxes, you can just pull the strap down and still access it. Obviously, you don't, you know, you're gonna have your back seat stored full of stuff while you're traveling, so you wanna be able to use the inverter without having to actually access the inverter itself. So what we've done in the tray, we've got a weatherproof 240 volt outlet in the back there, and the switch for the inverter is also on our socket panel in the back, so making it super easy and accessible that when they're in the back of the car, you know, they get their induction cooker out, whatever they're using, hit a button, flick your 240 volt GPO on, and away you go. You can plug whatever you want into it, and away you roll. So it is a 2000 watt inverter in this one. So 2000 watt inverters are good for most of your 240 appliances. So, you know, most single induction cooktops can quite easily cook off of one of them. Most of your coffee machines, smaller air fryers, all those sorts of things. You know, battery tool chargers, if you're taking some battery tools on the road with you, is able to obviously do all that. So it makes it a, you know, it gives you little creature comforts, I guess, while you're in the middle of nowhere.
Not a worry at all. Now, you've made mention of a 240 GPO in the rear. Now, obviously, being 240 volt, can you just run me through, I guess, how we do that, and obviously to make sure it's safe and legal still to meet the standard in 240 land?
Yeah, 100%. So we, obviously, yeah, the inverter we've used is an Enerdrive 2000 watt inverter. It's the model with the built-in RCD or RCBO, if you want to be specific. So essentially a safety switch. So that's a must if you're running a remote socket or remote GPO like we've done. So that means that if you have a faulty appliance that's, you know, no good, or if you're trying to plug something crazy too big into it, it'll trip that switch before you get any electrical shock or have any issues along those lines. We also, obviously, doing 240 work, have to get, you know, a qualified 240 volt electrician in. We sublet him in. He obviously checks it over, makes sure all the switches are tripping, all the safety stuff is working as it should, to make sure you don't get accidentally fried in the middle of nowhere.
Because we don't want that. So yeah, anything related to extra power points or anything like that to do with an inverter, you do need a licensed electrician to terminate, especially in caravans. So with caravans, we also have to ensure we get an updated safety certificate to ensure it complies with the standards in those realms. Now, Craig, before we move on to sockets and, you know, the other little bits and bobs we've done on this car, I just want to touch on one thing. Now, obviously there's a lot of legislations out about lithium batteries. Run me through, so, you know, the legislation saying in a caravan instance, we can't have them in a habitable area unless they are sealed. How's it different in a car?
Correct, so vehicles being that you're not sleeping in them, then they're not a habitable area per se. Your vehicles are, you know, still a mode of transportation. So in a car like the D-Max, where you're not going to be sleeping in the car itself, in the confined space where lithium battery is, those regulations don't apply per se. Obviously, you still want to be using a really top quality lithium battery that has all the protection devices inbuilt, but in terms of going to the, you know, the effort of sealing and venting directly outside, that's more so for caravans or for RVs or troop carriers, the likes of where you're actually going, your living quarters, habitable area is in with the lithium battery. In this, it's in behind the back seat. It's a mode of transportation. You're not going to live in the car, so not required for this one.
Easy. And extras. What else have we got going on in this thing?
Cool. So solar panel. Customer supplied his own solar panel on top of his rooftop tent. We've obviously wired that into the solar input side of the DC-DC so that when they're pulled up and stopped, having a coffee break on the side of the road, whatever, it's charging all the time as well, providing the sun shining. So that's obviously one little extra that's on there. Yeah, in terms of sockets, we've got one of our socket boxes on the back. So we've got a couple of Gray Anderson outlets. We've got Obviously a couple SIG sockets, voltmeter, all those sorts of things. So they've got, you know, a variety of sockets that they can plug in, you know, phone chargers and whatever else. So you're never gonna be short of, accessory sockets there. We have also put in a dedicated fridge circuit as well over the opposite side of the tub for the fridge, dedicated for the fridge, so it's separate to everything else. To separate all that, and yeah, I think that's about it. Oh, battery monitoring, something we have not discussed yet.
No.
So some lithium batteries are coming with a built-in Bluetooth monitor, some don't still, which is totally cool. These custom lithiums, to try and get them as compact as possible, they don't have that feature. So what we do instead, we run an external shunt. So you can think of a shunt as like a flow meter for your battery. So it's reading everything that's coming in or going out of your battery. So for this case, we've used the Victron Smartshunt. They're fairly cost effective, very compact, and they have a very simple, easy to use phone application for Android or Apple that you can log in really easily and see exactly, you know, what percentage your battery is at and how much current you're pulling.
Awesome, awesome. So yeah, look, really good basic, you know, touring build for just out of the car. Obviously he's got the rooftop tent on top, which is his sleeping quarters, so it's a very much an all-in-one, jump in your car and away you go. We're doing a lot more of these behind seat systems. Obviously you've probably seen on our stores and on our YouTube as well. We've got 100 amp options. We're very much pushing into the 200 amp options as well, because everyone wants to jump up to using an induction cooktop and coffee machines while out in the bush. Now, Craig, if you could, I'm going to hit you with one last question before we wrap this up.
Go for it.
What's your dream setup?
Ooh, that's a very, very good question.
You can't say
a
patrol.
Oh, it was always going to be a patrol. That was not ever a question. So, I'd probably say a chopped Y62 with a full canopy setup. Like a Bush Company rooftop tent, 200, 400 amperes of lithium in the back, full setup drawers, induction cooker. Yeah, that'd be the bee's knees, I reckon.
Awesome, guys. Well, thanks for tagging along for another one of our videos out here in the concrete campsite. This DMAX is a really good system for what this customer wants. Now, obviously, we specialize in tailoring a system to suit what you want, so please get in touch. As always, you can check out our other videos up here. YouTube thinks you should like this one. Please leave us a like, comment, and subscribe. And we will see you on the next one.
Bye-bye.
Accelerate off-grid touring, powering your adventures.